This SciShow video is supported by Linode. You can go to linode.com/scishow to learn more and get a $100 60-day credit on a new Linode account. There's nothing quite like the smell of the trees during a hike through the forest. But the molecules responsible for that lovely scent do more than just smell good. They're used by the trees for protection against pests and pathogens. Researchers have found that they even can help make clouds, which means that trees might not be complete bystanders when it comes to the weather around them. Their natural emission of cloud-forming molecules may be influencing the climate around them way more than we used to think possible. And since we need to understand exactly how our climate is changing, we're going to need to account for weather-controlling trees. Let's quickly go over some organic chemistry to understand how this works. Trees produce monoterpenes, using carbon dioxide that they collect from the atmosphere during photosynthesis. Monoterpenes are made up of 10 carbon atoms and 16 hydrogen atoms, and the exact arrangement produces slightly different compounds. The most abundant of these is alpha pinene. As the name suggests, it's responsible for the unique smell of pine trees. Once they're made, monoterpenes can be stored in the leaf, locking them up until the tree needs to use them. Otherwise, they're released by the tree immediately after they're produced. And trees emit a lot of monoterpenes, well over 100 teragrams of carbon per year. That's a 1 followed by 14 zeros grams. Up in the atmosphere, monoterpenes are quick to combine with ozone and hydroxyl molecules that are floating around up there. They form new particles that are the beginning stages of clouds, known as cloud condensation nuclei. There are a few ways clouds can get started, and research has shown that monoterpenes can be one. And while there's obviously a lot of variables, the thinking goes that these clouds lead to increased cooling as well as the potential for rain. Now, a monoterpene such as alpha pinene can actually exist in two forms, plus and minus alpha pinene, referred to as enantiomers. These molecules have the same atoms in the same arrangement, but they're mirror images of one another. It's often compared to left and right hands. Same basic arrangement, but you can't superimpose them onto each other no matter how hard you try. And there can be differences between the way enantiomers behave chemically. However, in this case, enantiomers of alpha pinene have the same reactivity with ozone and hydroxyl ions. And because these two forms react the same in the atmosphere, existing climate models don't differentiate between the two. But maybe they should. The authors of a 2022 paper in the journal Nature have found that these different forms of alpha pinene are released into the atmosphere at very different times, especially during periods of severe drought. These researchers look closely at the two forms in a closed-system controlled environment rainforest designed to simulate the Amazon basin. This is literally a rainforest in a really big box, where the chemical and climate conditions within can be controlled and measured by researchers. This means the researchers were able to do a few things they wouldn't be able to do in the natural environment. First, they could simulate the climate conditions they were interested in studying, which range from normal rainforest conditions to severe drought. And they could also add carbon-13, a form of carbon with an extra neutron that is used by researchers as a way to track environmental processes because it doesn't naturally occur in large quantities. Carbon-13 can be injected into the atmosphere within the box, where the trees will pick it up and use it just like the more common carbon-12. That helps researchers determine which form of the alpha pinene was being released throughout the experiment. If the alpha pinene contained the carbon-13 that was added during the experiment, that would mean it was created after they dosed the rainforest in a box with the stuff. And what the team found during normal conditions was that the trees released minus alpha pinene in the morning. And it was freshly made, released almost as soon as it was created by the trees during photosynthesis. In contrast, plus alpha pinene wasn't released until later in the afternoon. And it didn't contain any carbon-13. Which told the researchers that this form of alpha pinene was being released from some kind of tree internal storage system. So, even under normal rainforest conditions, the different forms of alpha pinene were being emitted at different times of the day. And as drought conditions progressed from mild to severe, the trees switched how they released the different forms of alpha pinene. and also started releasing a lot of monoterpenes in general, including other compounds like beta-pinene. The emission of minus alpha-pinene was delayed from morning until later in the day, which the researchers believe was in response to the stressful conditions created by the drought. Instead of releasing freshly made minus alpha-pinene, the trees conserved energy by releasing more of it from storage along with the plus alpha-pinene. And by releasing a lot more monoterpenes into the atmosphere, it was kind of like an SOS signal to the atmosphere, signaling for the clouds and rain in order to lessen the drought stress. Not that the trees know what they're doing, but it seems like a strong clue that trees have evolved ways to help ease drought conditions on a local scale. They're not totally at the mercy of the weather. It's a two-way conversation, and the trees talk with monoterpenes. All that suggests monoterpenes are more than just a nice smell to enjoy on a hike. Drought conditions are predicted to increase as the climate crisis continues to rage, so these molecules will become even more important in the future. This new research shows that even the different forms of monoterpenes are an important piece of the climate jigsaw puzzle, and it's important to understand how their emissions will change over time and accurately account for them in future climate models. In the end, those trees might be onto something. We all like making it rain. And to do that, we save money where we can. That's why Linode, a cloud computing company from Akamai, has straightforward and transparent pricing. They don't trick you into paying more than you can afford or more than you need with a big package that provides all sorts of services you'll never use. Linode lets you pay for only what you need, and their services scale up easily whenever you need more. But if money is tight right when you're looking to get started, they have a special $100 60-day credit on a new Linode account just for SciShow viewers like you. You can find that credit at linode.com/scishow or in the description down below. Thanks to Linode for supporting this SciShow video, and thank you for watching.